Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia. This is Abhishek Sharma. We are continuing with our economies, concepts and basics series. Now this is the next concept that we are following up after GDP. This is NNP, that is net national product. Now India's real national income, as stated by NSO, is calculated in the form of NNP or net national product. Now this net national product sirf itna simply nahi hai, wo bolte hain NNP at factor cost at constant prices. ये दो चीजें हैं. अब अगर आपने पिछला वीडियो देखा है तो उसके अंदर आपको मालूम होगा कि फैक्टर कॉस्ट एसेंशियली क्या है, कि ऑल दी फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन अगर हम उनको लें, जैसे रॉ मटेरियल, लेबर, कैपिटल एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, उन सबको जब एड अप करते हैं तो जो कॉस्ट आती है दैट इज फैक्टर कॉस्ट, राइट. एंड योर कॉन्स्टेंट प्राइजेस वही हैं जो बेस ईयर के अंदर हमने फिक्स किए थे इन द लास्ट वीडियो, दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट. सो एज इट इज एनएनपी के अंदर जो ये पैरामीटर्स हैं एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट एंड एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्राइजेस, वो इस तरह से हैं. नाउ एनएनपी जो नेट नेशनल प्रोडक्ट है, इसकी कैलकुलेशन कैसे होती है? तो इसका कंसर्न बेसिकली फॉर्मूला ऐसा है कि अगर आप जीडीपी के ऊपर, इफ यू आर देयर, सो जीडीपी से टूवर्ड्स जीएनपी यू कैन गो by adding one basic thing, that is net factor income from abroad. All right, and from GNP you can go to NNP by simply subtracting depreciation. These are two things that we have to learn in this video. What is this net factor income from abroad and what is this depreciation if you talk about national income aggregates. Now as far as net factor income from abroad is concerned, it has basically four components. Look at this. So NFIFA, first component, if you look at it, it is the trade balance. Trade balance matlab export revenue minus import expenditure. So India ke liye aam taur pe negative hai aur kafi negative hai. Now next aspect that we can look at it is interests net. See, India has taken loans from many countries, banks, etc. And we give loans also. So what is the net of those interest rates that we pay? So that is what we consider here. Then there is remittances net. So remittances ka concern jo hai, that is hamari log jo bahar gaye hue hain, jo paise wo India mein bhejte hain, hamari companies jo bahar hain, wo jo paise apni parent companies ko yahan pe bhejti hain, that is all remittances. Ek aur iske andar jo aspect aata hai, that is foreign aid. So India can give foreign aid and can receive foreign aid. तो इसका भी net हम यहाँ पे लेते हैं. अब इसमें से अब ध्यान से देखिए, तो एक तो trade balance India के लिए negative है, दूसरा जो interest है वो component हमारे लिए बहुत negative है. Foreign aid और remittances positive है. In fact India जो है वो NRI remittances को लेके number one in the world है. China is the second, we are the number one. पर ये इतना पॉजिटिव नहीं है कि बाकी दो negatives को वो बैलेंस कर पाए. और इस वजह से होता क्या है कि our NFIFA nutshell में is negative. Because of this, what essentially happens is your GDP is more than your GNP. Hona to ye tha ki GDP plus NFIFA is equal to GNP, par kyunki ek negative quantity hai to isliye hamara GNP thoda sa aur kam nazar aata hai. Now moving on, minus depreciation. So depreciation ka concern hota hai consumption of fixed capital se. इसके जो फिगर्स हैं वो गवर्नमेंट खुद फिक्स करती है कि कितना डेप्रिसिएशन है. एसेंशली हम जब गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज बनाते हैं तो हमारी मशीनरी या जो फिक्स्ड कैपिटल है वो ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम उसकी वैल्यू कम होती है. तो ये भी एक कंसिडरेशन हम अपनी नेशनल इनकम एस्टिमेट्स के अंदर लेते हैं. तो इसको जब माइनस करते हैं तो हमारे पास एक अच्छा फिगर आता है, दैट इज नेट नेशनल प्रोडक्ट. दैट गिव्स यू अ मोर रिलायबल पिक्चर ऑफ व्हाट योर इकोनॉमी इज लुकिंग लाइक राइट नाउ in terms of your national income. So that's why the real national income of India is calculated on the basis of NNP at factor cost at constant prices, right? So the reason why we take it at factor cost is we don't want the impact of production taxes, product taxes and so on, yeah, or production subsidies or product subsidies and so on. We take it at factory level, what is happening, right? Reason why we take it at constant prices is so that we can trace it over a period of time, because current prices are always wavering like this. Aaj aap dekh rahe hain pyaaz kahin 100 rupaye kilo ke hisab se bik raha hai, kahin 200 rupaye kilo ke hisab se bik raha hai. To is tarah se commodities to upar niche jaati rahengi, isliye zaruri hai ki unke prices fix kiye jaye taki aap ek consistent imagery draw kar saken ki aapki economy upar ja rahi hai ya niche ja rahi hai. based on production kitna hua in these goods and services, right? Now, if you look at the questions on this area, so practice questions ke andar dekhi, UPSC ke andar ye 2001 ka question hai. The most appropriate measure of economic growth is very simple question they have asked, that is net national product. So that's how you have to consider it. Okay, so as it is, NNP ke level pe aap dekhenge to same aapke paas figures aayengi. US has the biggest economy in the world as it is, and followed by there's a big economy size in China now, there is a big economy size in many other countries. India wahi jaise hum baat karte hain nominal level pe, ki we are the 7th largest economy, so that's where we fall up. All right, so iske baad jo next video hai usme will be decoding some more basic concepts on economy, so stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that you get alerts on all our new videos. So whenever this live session is happening again, so you can be in touch with us. Thank you so much. This is me, Abhishek Sharma, signing off. All the best for your exams. Thank you.